different songs anymore. But no, what does it matter? There's so many more important things happening in the world. Why should I trouble you with my small sadness? Like last year, in August, most terrible thing happened to our country. We gained independence. Everyone was awake, waiting for midnight. Like children on the last day of school, waiting for the last bell of the last class before vacation. And they're rushing out and screaming and shouting and fighting.
Baby, that's... the proper challenge today that will burn the streets tomorrow.
We are few.
Sit down. Are you hurt?
Just a little. Nothing serious.
Let me see. Repeat in black and blue.
I will be all right.
Where are you from?
Jeevnagar.
Are you in college?
I'm in college. He dropped out.
Why did you come to this city?
Why did you bring some attack on our head?
What do you want me to do? Throw them out to be butchered?
No.
Then bring them a glass of water. They are guests in our house now. So, what are you doing in this area?
We came to visit a friend.
Yes, you may sleep here tonight, but I want you to be out of my house in the morning.
Thank
sorry, we don't have any extra mattresses, but here are some sheets and pillows.
I'm in a dream.
What do you mean? He doesn't have a proper home.
Oh yes, you said you didn't live with your parents. He's looking for a job. That's why we came to the city. I came too to help him.
Perhaps I can help him. I have a sari shop in Kapta Bazaar. Not a very big shop. No, it used to be. But I could use your help. The shop is all we have now. We had a mill, but I got rid of it. I should have gotten rid of the shop and kept the mill. You like the job? You can handle those ball and women women. We usually pass by our showroom. You can stand outside and call them in. What do you say?
Please.
I'll be very happy if you say yes. It will be my pleasure to give that job. That shop, it used to be. Take the job, please.
No.
No?
You can't. You must not.
What do you mean?
You don't know what he really is.
Please.
They threw him out. He didn't leave his parents. His father threw him out. Tasneem told me. They hire him. They hire such people. They who? Those parties. They bring him and many more to this city to create riot. To throw the first stone, they pay them to do it.
Should we be swallowed up? Lily cannot recognize us. Should we bend into anonymity so they cannot harm us? Lose ourselves in a shapeless mass. Should we? Can we?
Violence on your mind. Your life is based on violence. Your religion is based.
There is no danger outside now. Come back and they will return.
Let him go. You stay. You can leave tomorrow. I don't believe in a word he said. He is just a pet criminal. How can I keep him here knowing?
Javed, come back. I am taking a walk. I need some air.
He didn't do it for the money.
They didn't hire him. He wanted here.
Doesn't that make him even more repulsive?
No, it doesn't.
What he has done is unforgivable. I don't think he will change. But still, I'm willing to try. If you wish, you can bring him tomorrow to my shop.
You condemn him. You feel what he has done is hateful. And yet you want him to work in a shop. Why?
I have to give him all chances I can possibly give. No, that's not the real reason.
Then what is it?
How long have you known him?
We grew up together, went to school together. Pardon me for saying this, sir. If you find his actions repulsive, you're also in some ways partly responsible.
I? Responsible for the action of that pathetic boy?
He has changed. Believe me, he has changed. At one time, many years ago, when we were still in school, Javed was a hero. Smart, brave. A minor incident changed all of that. It started with a cricket match. We were playing cricket on our street with the younger boy. The postman delivered our neighbor's mail. By mistake, he dropped one of the letters. He was in a hurry and asked Javed to hand the letter to the owner. Javed took the letter and opened the gate. Immediately, a voice boomed.
What do you want?
I can still remember Javed holding out the letter and mumbling something. His usual confidence was gone in a second.
Leave it alone!
The voice ordered. Javed backed away, really frightened. The postman came after them. We all followed the man as he came outside with a cloth in his hand. He wiped the letter before picking it up. He wiped the spot of the wall where the letter was, and he wiped the gate. We stared at him as he went inside. The postman came after the next time and grinned when he saw this. That man is slightly cracked, he said. We heard the prayer bell ringing continuously. The neighbor had been praying for quite a while, but none of us noticed this bell before. We heard the bell so often every day of our life that it didn't mean anything. It was the part of the sound of birds and winds, but at that moment, you heard only the bell. The next day, the neighbor came up screaming on the street. He was furious, with tears running down his face. Somebody had dropped pieces of meat and bone in his backyard. I didn't speak to Javed for many days after that. I was frightened of him for months. Whenever we played cricket and heard the bell, we remembered that incident and avoided looking at Javed. And for Javed, he was in his own eyes, no longer the neighbor hero.
Looking up at me, it is approval.
after the bus stop. I'm sure in morning there will be some buses leaving.
And?
We will go back.
You are old.
And the job?
I don't know.
You can't leave?
There's nobody outside. So
there's one important thing I cannot forget.
What's that?
That you are a criminal. I can't allow you to just leave.
We have no proof of anything.
What do you want to do?
Turn you over to the police.
I did not thought of going to jail. It would be so funny for you.
Pardon us, but that was a very nice thing to say.
You mean they won't arrest you?
Arrest me? When they have been looking the other way all along? How do you think we came onto the street? In their vans. They will arrest me. Don't worry. To please people like you, plus a few innocent Muslims, to please everyone.
Perhaps I should throw you to the mob.
Perhaps you should.
They seem to have disappeared.
Chariot as it was planned. The pujari fell to the ground.
I
pushed him aside just as the chariot began to fall. We escaped in a panic and a confusion. You are brave. Not everyone could have stopped.
Sit with him. She knew I couldn't. She wanted me to go away.
I didn't know what to do, so I sat. I sat and watched as they ate those things. My head started spinning from the smell. I could feel my stomach churning and I vomited. Then and there, Sarin stood up. I thought she would help me, but she screamed at me instead. I just ran outside. Kanta was waiting with the rickshaw, looking really angry. She took me home. Later, Kanta told me that Hari had tried to help Sarin's father by offering to buy the stupid burnt-up shop. But they were so ungrateful that his father just patted her face. What horrible people! Horrible people!
Why, Smita said that. Have you ever thought of going to Pakistan?
No.
Why not? There is a little living one without blaming other people for a failure. We were smart. Me and my family. We left Islamabad to come to India. Did you know that?
No.
My father died in Islamabad. We never came as great brothers like you. As my father and I did, just pray to the truth. Pulling our eyes at Krishna and pray for his life.
That is not our fault.
Then whose fault is it?
You blame us for what happened 50 years ago. Tomorrow if something happens to my sister, can I blame you?
She deserves it. Your sister deserves it. Very deserves. What did you say sister's name was?
Tasneem.
Oh, I thought you were Hari.
No, it is not true, Hari. No, I did not touch the food. Don't do that. I swear I didn't do anything. Stop it. Stop it. Please, I'll never go there again. Please.
They hurt me so much. All those hurting people. I lost respect forever in that moment because of that cursed family.
They are not to blame.
You don't understand how I feel.
I can. It is not their fault.
I wish somehow we could start again. Perhaps